Welcome, everybody, to the 2018 Brookline High School commencement. Please rise.
Thank you.
welcome our class marshals, Melissa Boo and Jimmy Ricks, to the stage. We will now have the playing of our national anthem. Thank you to Mike Driscoll and Camerata once again. Thank you, Melissa and Jimmy. Good afternoon. What a glorious day. My name is Lisa Redding, and I am the dean for the dynamic class of 2018. Would our students giving our international welcome please come on stage? At Brookline High School, we take great pride in our diversity. One of the many ways in which we are diverse is in the 70 languages spoken by our students in our hallways. Today, we offer you greetings in some of those languages.
Hi, my name's Andrea Wetzler and my family's from Norway. Og? Velkommen alle til Brookline sin videregående skole sin avslutningsfest for seniorene I klassen av 2018. Gratulerer til alle!
Hi, my name is Neelab Sharma. My family is from India. Brookline High School ki graduation ceremony mein aapka swagat hai.
Hi, my name is Sean Higgins, and my family's from Poland. And you, And you can say, Cześć, mam na imię Sean Higgins I gratulujemy wszystkich studentów, które gradują w klasie 2018 roku.
Hello, my name is Hannah Stern-Pite. My family is from Brazil. Oi, bem-vindos ao formatura do Brookline High School.
Hello, my name is Simon Ivčević, and my father is from Croatia. I dobrodošli u srednju školu na Brookline.
Hello, my name is Ayasa Michi, and I'm from Japan. 2018年 Brookline High School の卒業式へようこそ。
Hello, my name is Carolina, and I'm from France. Bienvenue à la remise des diplômes 2018 de PHS.
Hi, my name is Lando, my family from Haiti. Merci à tout le monde qui vini. Et me souhaite nous passer une bonne journée.
Hi, my name is Daniela Fuentes Hernandez. My family is from Mexico. Y bienvenidos a la clase, a la graduación de la clase 2018 de Brooklyn High School.
Hi, my name is Maya Cassis. My family is from Syria. أهلاً وسهلاً بكم في حفل تخرج أطفال سنوية بروكلاين لعام 2018.
Hi, my name is Salam Kasu. My family is from Ethiopia. أكوانا درا ساتشو يا هولات الشياس راس منت مرقا. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Juliet. I am from Haiti. Bienvenue à la graduation Brookline High School 2018.
Hi, my name is Christina Ye, and my family is from South Korea. 안녕하세요, Brookline High School 졸업식에 오신 것을 환영합니다.
Hi, my name is Avi Benmayor, and my family is from Turkey. Merhabalar, Brookline High School 2017-2018 mezuniyet törenine hoş geldiniz.
My name is Chris Hernandez. My family is from Thailand. And ยินดีต้อนรับทุกคนที่งานรับปริญญาตรีโรงเรียนมัธยมบุ๊คไลน์ 2018 ครับ
Hi, my name is Anthony Vietti. My family is from the Republic Democratic of Congo. So, mbote na batu nyoso.
Hi, my name is Komal Vasif and my family is from Pakistan. Kushamadi Gurwala Urdosto.
Hello, my name is Eppo Strauss, and I'm from the Netherlands. Welkom bij de uitreiking van Brookline High School.
Hi, my name is Diart Spahia, and I'm from Kosovo. Mirsavini to Brookline High School, VT Skolori classes at Dumia Tetmet. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Arianna Tecker. I'm from Italy. Benvenuti alla laurea di Brookline High School.
Hello, my name is Mary Corcoran, and I'm a fourth generation graduate of Brookline High School. My mother, Gail Riley, graduated in 1983, and my father, Craig Corcoran, graduated in 1982. My maternal grandfather, Paul Riley, graduated in 1951, and my paternal grandfather, Thomas Corcoran, graduated in 1943. My maternal great-grandfather, James Riley, graduated in 1921. My grandmother, Madeline Corcoran, taught at BHS for 40 years, and my other grandmother, Janet Riley, worked in the BHS Science Department for many years. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the Brookline High School graduation for the class of 2018.
It is now my honor to introduce to you the man who 2 years ago stepped up to replace the irreplaceable Dean Anthony Meyer. the man who settled into his position with ease and poise, my partner in deaning this senior class, Dean Brendan Kobus.
So first, I want to give a big thank you to the incredible Dean Redding and to the class of 2018. It has been both an honor and a joy to work with this class and with Dean Redding the past 2 years. I can't believe we're here at the end of this journey with you all. I'd like to give a welcome to the many special guests we have here this afternoon. Welcome to the members of the BHS class of 1968. Welcome to our keynote speaker, Mr. Chris Dempsey. Welcome to assembled members of the Brookline School Committee. Welcome to our Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Andrew Bott, and members of district leadership. Welcome to our Head of School, Mr. Anthony Meyer. Welcome to BHS administrators, faculty and staff, elementary school faculty and staff, and most importantly, families, friends, and graduates. Now I'd like to introduce the chair of the Brookline School Committee, David Pollack, who will welcome the class of 1968.
Good afternoon, everyone, and congratulations, class of 2018. Welcome back, members of the class of 1968. Brookline High School is a place of incredible student activism and engagement, and you were here at the awakening. A little more than 50 years ago, you all arrived back on campus for your senior year, fresh from the summer of love, something that no doubt caught your attention. Apparently, this cultural awakening also caught the attention of the school committee because sex education showed up right alongside you at BHS that year. The class of 68 led the student power movement at Brookline High, and you advocated for expanded rights for all students. You created petitions, rallied for political candidates, and raised questions about America's growing involvement in the Vietnam War. You busted the dress code so girls could wear pants and boys could at least try to grow facial hair. When Martin Luther King was assassinated that spring, you spontaneously gathered together right here in front of school and held a vigil of silent meditation. 2 months later, in the wake of the assassination of Bobby Kennedy, you collected more than 1,000 student signatures in under 90 minutes and sent them to our delegation in Washington writing, "We, the undersigned youth of Brookline High School, in recognition of the lack of adequate gun control laws and the tragic loss of some of America's greatest leaders, pledge ourselves in support of strict and immediate gun control legislation to be passed by the Congress of the United States." So class of 68, you led the way with student engagement. Now, meet the class of 2018. Today, Brookline High School is wide awake. This year, our students have been increasing awareness and changing how racism and bigotry shape lives and outcomes within our school. Back in the fall, a student delegation again attended MSAN, the Minority Student Achievement Network Conference in Ohio. What was different this year was what these students did when they got back, developing and presenting their action plan to strengthen communication and collaboration throughout the school, and to document and then correct discrepancies in disciplinary actions at BHS. In November, racist videos disrupted the BHS community, and students responded with walkouts where they spoke, read poetry, and called for action. They called the entire community into open and honest conversation, which included the first use of restorative justice circles, a powerful new alternative discipline approach at BHS. At Asking for Courage Day, the entire school community joined in conversations, panels, and performances, awakening minds, building community, and encouraging action in the continuing work towards racial justice. And at the annual Day of Dialogue, another one of BHS's days of awareness and action, the community came together around LGBTQ+ rights. Student activism at BHS extends beyond the walls of the high school, across our town, our nation, and our world. BHS students engaged in inquiry about how Christopher Columbus and American history are taught and brought their concerns all the way through Brookline Town Meeting, which passed a resolution establishing Indigenous Peoples Day. A few weeks ago, BHS students participated in the National School Walkout Against Gun Violence, echoing the petition U68 sent to Washington almost exactly 50 years ago today. In their actions, our students show us hope in their energy and engagement, concern at the vast work that still remains, and expectation that each one of us, young and young-ish, be awake and working to build the just society that we all deserve.
And now I'd like to invite to the stage an all-star team of seniors from several of our school-wide a cappella groups performing Florence and the Machines, The Dog Days Are Over, as arranged by Noah Sessling.
Hi everyone, my name is Noah Sessling. These are all of the seniors from Notify, Perfect Pitch, and Testosetones, the three student-led a cappella groups here at Brookline High School. We're gonna be performing Dog Days Are Over by Florence and the Machine, arranged by myself, with solos by Lyra Johnson, Denise, and Mitchell, who are the three seniors who have been in the a cappella groups since freshman year.
The horses are coming. two, three.
Run fast for your mother, fast for your father. Run for your children, for your sisters and brothers. Leave all your love and you're running out. You can't take it with you if you want to survive. The dog days are over. The dog days are gone. Can you hear the horses? Cause here they come. The dog days are over. The dog days are gone. Can you hear the horses? Cause here they come.
Our dear seniors, this is our very last assembly. I know you are heartbroken, as our assemblies are always riveting, but this is the last time we will all gather as the class of 2018. In less than 2 hours from now, you will be graduates of Brookline High School. And we know that you have learned a lot in your time here.
Over these past years, we've learned so much from you. We've learned by watching you and knowing you. And we'd like to share a few things that you have imprinted upon us that help us become better educators. You may recognize these as our BHS mantras, but really, these mantras come from observing you and seeing you grow, try, fail, strive to improve, and build relationships.
Think back to your first day at BHS, to the welcoming, cheering staff who lined up to greet you, to your hesitation and excitement in being at this big school. Are you that same person that you were on that day? How have you changed? No doubt you have been challenged throughout your high school years. These challenges may have been academic, athletic, or emotional. You have shown us that you have learned something through each challenge. You changed your viewpoint after being convinced of another's argument. You made a mistake or a bad choice, and you learned something in the process. You know the cool thing about being human? We have the opportunity to learn and grow from our mistakes and our shortcomings. You taught us that you are not done yet. You have changed and grown during your time at BHS, and you're still not done yet. You have much more learning and growing to do, and that is super exciting. As you do this, keep an open mind and be open to change.
Class of 2018, we've watched you struggle. We've watched you challenge yourself. We've watched you step outside your comfort zone and try new things. We've seen you perform in a play when you have never acted before. We've seen you take an honors English class when you were sure you were a math person. We've seen you meet teachers after school so you could keep up with your AP bio class. You've taught us that this is hard, you can do it, and we will help you. We will take this lesson with us, and we want you to bring it with you on the next step of your journey. Continue to seek challenges for yourself. Trying to do something hard is a great way to learn. But find people who can help you, because trying to do something hard with someone to help is even better.
We watched you create the culture that you wanted at BHS. You felt like an injustice was done at our school, and you organized a protest. You looked at the inequities in the world, and you organized a hunger banquet. You saw people that needed companionship, and you organized the senior to senior prom. You wanted to change Brookline High School policy, and you joined legislature. You saw the need for not simply tolerance, but for acceptance and inclusion. And you organized and participated in the Day of Dialogue and Asking for Courage Day. You taught us that you create the culture that you want, and we want you to continue creating the culture you want in this world. And we learned that you are the change agents to do that.
Finally, we watched you navigate the balance of freedom and responsibility. Over the years, some of you may have broken a few rules and realized there are consequences. You may have even skipped a class and received a phone call or a detention. You also learned to navigate open campus, and you learned to manage your own schedule. By doing this, you taught us that it's all about freedom and responsibility. Many of the people your age that you will meet on the next steps of your journey won't have experienced the freedom that you've experienced. Continue to lead by example by always pairing freedom with responsibility.
We have reminded you of our four mantras, and we hope we carry them with you into your next phase of life. We also hope you remember your mindfulness training. So I think you're saying that you need some reminders. Great. I will remind you to stop and take a deep breath. Be in the moment, this one right now. Some stress can be good. You need to be kind to yourself, forgiving of yourself. Responding instead of reacting obtains better results. And finally, there is gratitude and the belief that it is not happiness that makes us grateful, but it is gratefulness that makes us happy. So let's make ourselves happy right now.
In that spirit, I know that so many of you wrote thank you notes to staff members or recorded messages of thank you. And as a dean and as a teacher, I can't even begin to tell you how much that means to me and all of us. So right now, I want you all to take one moment to be grateful. Close your eyes and think of a guidance counselor, a social worker, a staff member, or especially a family member that helped you grow and become who you are today, and spend a moment being grateful to them.
It feels good, doesn't it? I too would like to give thanks to a very special teacher, dean, colleague, and friend, Dean Scott Butchart. Dean Butchart was my teacher when I was a student at Brookline High School many years ago. I really had no interest in learning French at the time, but I loved going to Mr. Butchart's class. Being in his class helped me understand what great teaching is about: relationships. And as my dean colleague, he continued to teach me, mentor me, and I am grateful for all that he has done for me. After serving Brookline High School for 34 years as a teacher, soccer coach, ski coach, yearbook advisor, associate dean, Dean of Students, Scholarship Committee Chair, and Master of Ceremonies at our scholarship breakfast, representative to the Brookline Community Foundation Scholarship Committee, liaison to the Town of Brookline Scholarship Fund, all this while having a life of his own with his wife and four beautiful children. Dean Bouchard will retire at the end of this school year. Thank you, Scott, for all that you have done for me, for our students, and for Brookline High School. Let us return to this moment, your moment. To each of you as individuals and to this class as a whole, we have loved working with you during your years at BHS, and we are so excited to see and hear about your futures. Enjoy your commencement.
Now I'd like to introduce our first student speaker this afternoon. Please welcome Senior Ben Kimia.
Hi, my name is Ben Kimia. I am 6'4" tall. I weigh 185 pounds. And this year, I am your student graduation speaker. But to be honest, this year, I failed my math midterm. Despite what my parents might have told you, I am not the valedictorian. To be honest, I'm not sure what the equation for an ellipse is. I can't name three causes for the War of 1812. I don't know how big a mole is or what a mole is. I don't know why that matters. It's safe to say I have not been the perfect student at BHS. Sorry, Mom. But I'm not trying to say my time here was wasted. I think I've seen some pretty cool things. I watched Powder Puff turn into Power Puff. I watched two lunches turn into three lunches. I watched the cafeteria switch food providers not once, but twice. I watched the food at the cafeteria get a lot worse not once, but twice. Yeah, I've seen a lot here, and I've managed to learn some things somewhere along the way. The first lesson I learned was from a guy named Dr. Vic. I'm sure a lot of you know him. When I was a freshman, my sister, who was a senior, did mock trial. I'm naturally a pretty introverted person, so I thought this would be an easy way for me to make friends. I signed up, I read the information practice, and I attended my first practice, and I hated it. I really hated it. It was so boring, the practices were so long, and I wasn't making any new friends. But whenever I saw Dr. Vic in the hallway, he would look at me and he goes, "What's up, champion?" And that made me feel really good about myself. But sadly, after 2 weeks, I had decided it was time for me to quit. I walked to Dr. Vic's office after school one day, and I was nervous because, you know, I thought he was a cool guy, and I wanted him to like me, and I feared I would lose his friendship. I told him that mock trial just wasn't for me, and he took it very well. He said, "Don't worry about it, Mr. Kimia, and don't ever apologize for being yourself." I was relieved at the time, but I didn't realize how important his words were. I spent a lot of time trying to be popular and pretending I was someone else until I realized that didn't make me happy. I started being myself, I stopped trying to be cool, and that's when I started making friends. And whenever I saw Dr. Vic in the hallway, he would say the same thing. The second lesson I learned was from my teammate, Zach Altshuler. When I was a freshman, I joined the crew team, and when I was a sophomore, I quit the crew team. I wasn't making any progress, and I didn't feel like the camaraderie was worth the effort. One day, my old teammate, Ibi Ogba, pressured me into coming back for one day just to see if I was sure about quitting. Reluctantly, I came to practice. I saw a lot of unfamiliar, intimidating faces. I still had my friends from before I quit, but they had all branched out and formed new social circles. I was sitting alone before practice, and Zach came up to me, and he said, "Ben, I'm really glad you're here today. We've all missed you a lot." I don't think he knew, but him saying that meant so much to me. He was a senior, he was the captain of the team, and he went out of his way so that I felt welcome. I started working hard, I joined the team again, and last year, I was voted captain of the team. And it was only when I had that leadership position that I understood the importance of Zach's words. You never know how someone is feeling. You never know what they're going through. Saying something small to make them know you care can make a huge difference. And I hope that this past year, with that same empathy and compassion, I can bring my teammates the happiness that Zach brought me on that day. The third lesson I learned was from a guy named Kendrick Lamar. I think a few of you know him. In a song off Kendrick Lamar's debut album, Section 80, he says a quote that has stuck with me since the first time I heard it. He says, "I'm not on the outside looking in. I'm not on the inside looking out. I'm in the dead center looking around." I'm not popular. I'm not unpopular. I'm not a nerd. I'm not a jock. If I spend my whole life comparing myself to other people, I'm going to go insane. If I spend my whole life trying to give myself labels or trying to fit into some group, I'm going to go insane. At this point in my life, I can confidently say that I only adhere to three labels. My name is Ben Kimya, I'm 6'4" tall, and I weigh 185 pounds. I think that all in all, the big takeaway I learned in my 4 years here is that everyone around you is just someone trying to do their best. When the seniors skip class or when the freshmen run through the hallway so they get to class on time, they're just doing what they think is right. I hope that as I enter this next stage in my life, I can remember that everyone around me is just trying to do their best. Thank you, it's been an honor.
I am not 6'4", so I'm gonna pull the microphone down. I'd now like to introduce seniors Jason Altshuler and Jackson Lewitt performing Bob Dylan's My Back Pages.
Check 1, 2. All right. Yeah, just warming up. I know we're not a cappella, but bear with us. We'll do our best. I'm Jason. This is Jack. We actually went to preschool together, And we've been playing music together for like 6 years now. But it was really Brookline High School that allowed us to kind of really play together and get to know each other's musicians and play with other people, and so many great performance opportunities. So really have a big debt to VHS. So thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Great. It is my pleasure to welcome to the stage our next student speakers, Yamanuchi Estime and Salam Kasu. Ready to graduate? Because I know I am. That's what I thought. Harriet Tubman once said, "Every great dream begins with the dreamer. Always remember you have within strength, patience, and the passion to reach for the stars and change the world."
Michael Dell once said, "As you start your journey, the first thing you should do is throw away that store-bought map and begin to draw your own." Throughout our 4 years of high school, we learned a lot of words of wisdom that will help us throughout our futures and stay with us forever.
Don't work for free. Know your value.
Learn how to finesse the system, and how bad do you really want it?
I can only lead you to the well, but I can't make you drink.
Brookline High School, a place that will always be in our hearts. No matter how many times we wanted to leave, we can't say it didn't teach us anything. When we leave and go off to our adventures next year, whether that be job, gap year, military, or college, et cetera, look for a familiar face from BHS and know that you'll always have a safe place to call home.
We update the teachers. We bother them now, so why stop there? We suggest that you all keep in touch with your guidance counselors, deans, a BHS staff member that you trusted throughout your years, and let them know how you're doing throughout your journey in the future. Take life's lessons that you were taught and bring it with you to wherever you may go.
Be proud of yourself today and soak it in. We did it. We really did. I thought saying that in eighth grade was crazy, but look at where we are now. I look back to a measly old Facebook post that I made 4 years ago, and I thought, that was it. I made it. That was my peak. And this is where life gets easier. And I was so wrong. But I was so right. I thank the school and everyone for all that it's taught me. I thank my friends who showed me the power of my voice and the knowledge that we all share. I thank so many people here for the experiences and what they have done for me. Most importantly, I thank you to the families and support systems that got us here today. Thank you for everything. Look at them right now. We'll give you guys a moment and just give them a little nod or mouth a quick thank you, if you guys can find them. And make it very clear later how grateful you are for them, for driving you to all those basketball practices, even though they didn't have to, for taking care of you when you were sick, when you were nothing but a pain, or for having all the faith to send you off on international trips when all they want to do is hold on to you tight before you leave the nest.
So, before you guys go off, we want to give you a Salaam and Yama foolproof step-by-step of what you should do when you officially graduate. If this doesn't work, we don't know what will, but let's just give this a shot.
Step one, it's okay to make mistakes.
Okay, like the time I said microscope when I really want to say microphone, and my best friend, Principal Meyer, whispered on the microphone that I said microscope. Step two, always have a good support team.
Your support team is a group of people who are always encouraging you, strengthening you to become a better person, and most importantly, pushing you to do bigger and better things. You want supportive people and people on your team who are grinding and have a plan. If you have dreams and aspirations and you're going out every night and wondering why you aren't where you want to be, look at your friends. Are those the people who are going to support you to get to the top? Show me your friends and I'll tell you who you are. Do they have dreams? What are they working for? Do they even have goals? And if you can't see these people pushing you to do better, then it's time to push them out the door. Step three, always take care of yourself.
It's very important to be self-aware of your wants and needs. Mentally and physically, life can drain you out. In the future, if this ever happens to you and you turn out to be a broke college student with 27 cents in the bank and nothing seems to be going right, get a job. Make sure the first thing you do is get a paycheck and go to the movies, hang out with friends and family, or better yet, travel the world if you want to. Make sure you put yourself first and learn that sometimes short care term is just as important as long care term. If these steps don't resonate, then take one thing. Always be grateful, thankful, and aware. Take that with you everywhere you go, and I promise you, you'll do just fine.
We walked into BHS hearing from a junior mentor, and she asked us to do a shout out for our schools. We believe that the way that we have entered the school should be the very same way that we leave. And we're going to ask for you guys to do this for one last time.
Lawrence! Y'all are not gonna cheer.
Who went to Lawrence? Driscoll.
Lincoln.
Heath.
Runkle.
Pierce.
Baker. And Devo!
And to all those who have joined us over the years, we ask that you use this time to have your own little shout out. So if you've joined over the past couple years, and now that we ask you guys to shout out for Brookline High. Here's to our memories and what our futures hold for us.
Thank you for our families and friends for making these 4 years amazing.
Yep. And we want to leave you guys with one last thing.
Yeah! Thank you.
Thank you, Yama and Salaam. Now I'd like to invite our senior class advisor, Ms. Erin Blett, and members of the Senior Steering Committee on stage for the presentation of the senior class gift. Yeah, you can all line up here. As Dean Redding mentioned earlier, one enduring piece of the legacy that Dean Bouchard will leave at Brookline High School was his commitment to supporting Brookline High students in their next steps through his work chairing the BHS Scholarship Committee. Dean Bouchard has worked tirelessly to help find ways to lower the financial hurdles that can come with higher education for thousands of our graduates. That is why the class of 2018 would like to contribute $2,000 in his name to the Brookline Community Foundation. Thank you, Dean Scott Bouchard.
Future generations will be thanking you.
It is now my honor to introduce to you our head of school, Mr. Anthony Meyer.
Let's go, 18. Come on now. It's your day. All right. I have two purposes for my turn here at the lectern. One, I'm going to share a poem I wrote for and to you, class of 2018. Two, it is my honor eventually to introduce our commencement speaker, Chris Dempsey. So first, a little poem I cooked up for you. All right. 18, done and not done yet. 18, you are done. Done with high school homework, rules, PA drone, done. 18, you are done. Well, well done work in classrooms and all spaces, BHS havens of thought and learning, obstacle, opportunity. As a boy about your age, I often gawked up and out, seeing sky as nature dome. I embraced the sheer expanse and the limits of a single sight line, vanishing points. Entranced I was by others' sky domes, how everyone beholds different worlds. Today you leave this sky dome we've shared, Cypress Field, UA, Tappan, Schlunz, BHS, and the 115, you are done. 18, you are not done yet. Being, becoming, moving, straining, muscle and mind, your most sacred dome, the head, melded with heart, whole self change, hard to fathom at 17 or 18 or 47. You are not done yet. We need your future self stories, sharing word from future domes you will grace, near, far, now, and all the nows ahead. June 3rd, 2018, and I am not a boy about your age, and yet gawk up and out, seeing sky as nature dome. Sensing, knowing, loving all you have done and will do. I and we, BHS, will miss you and we love you. 18, you are done and not done yet. Don't say a school administrator never wrote you a poem, because that's not true. All right, now I have the pleasure of presenting Chris Dempsey to you. He literally grew up right over there. You can actually see his house between the UA and the swimming pool. He grew up on Brington Road, attended the Pierce School, which you can't see, but you can sense right over there. He went there from preschool through eighth grade. He played JV basketball with PSB Metco director Keith Lazama, and he probably played it there and there. His coach was Mr. Theodore, who's a math teacher here. He learned calculus himself from Ms. Costant. He worked on a little newspaper you might have heard called The Sagamore. Really? No Sagamore? You have to be quiet right now. There we go. He graduated from BHS in 2001 and organized his class 10th year reunion in 2011. And Chris's junior semi happened in the same place, the basement of the Holiday Inn on Beacon Street. Oh, how times have changed. Your junior semi was on a boat. Come on now. All right. After Chris graduated from Brookline High School, he went to Pomona College in California, where at least one of you is going next year. Eventually, he headed to Harvard Business School, where he earned an MBA. He has been active in Brookline and Boston politics for his entire professional life. He worked on many statewide and local political campaigns, including serving as policy director for Congressman Joe Kennedy III. He served as the Assistant Secretary of Transportation for the Commonwealth. As part of his work there, Chris co-founded the MBTA's Open Data Program, the first of its kind on the East Coast. This allowed the creation of myriad real-time transit smartphone applications. In 2015, Chris was named Bostonian of the Year by the Boston Globe magazine for his volunteer work leading the No Boston Olympics campaign. More locally, Chris is a town meeting member representing Precinct 6, as well as the chairman of the Brookline Transportation Board. He currently serves as the director of Transportation for Massachusetts, abbreviated T4MA. Transportation for Massachusetts is a diverse coalition of more than 70 member and partner organizations working together to provide safe, convenient, environmental friendly, and affordable transportation for all, for all. Chris is an example of so much we value at BHS. Engaging in the world around him, doing so by working incredibly well with others, and using collaboration to push individuals and systems to be and do their best for everyone in our communities. It is my honor to introduce Brookline High School graduating class of 2001 alum Christopher Dempsey.
Thank you, Head of School Meyer. I knew that you were a great administrator. I did not know you were also a great beat poet. Members of the BHS class of 2018, it is an honor to be with you. Thank you for sharing this special day with all of us who are part of the extended Brookline High community. Faculty, staff, parents, alumni, and the neighbors who just stumbled across this ceremony while walking their dogs on Cypress Field. Ma'am, thank you for picking that up. Appreciate that. I'm gonna shatter the suspense and get the awkward part of this speech out of the way at the beginning. Last year's graduation speaker gave every member of the BHS class of 2017 free Red Sox tickets. I don't have any tickets for you. I'm sorry. Don't be mad at me. Be mad at your parents for not conceiving you 12 months earlier. What I can do for you is try to keep this speech short. It will be over quicker than you can put out a chemical fire at the Unified Arts Building. That was a pretty aggressive senior prank, guys. In exchange for being brief, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. And actually, Yama and Salam, asked you to do two of them already, so I'm going to repeat those. And even then, we'll do a TLDR at the end of this for those of you who want to zone out. But here we go. My father's aunt owned a simple gray shingle beach house in Hull, Massachusetts. And I used to spend a lot of time there with my family as a kid. It sat on a bluff above a quiet, typical, rocky New England beach and coastline. And on a number of occasions growing up, while walking on that beach or scampering over the rocks along the water, I discovered a message in a bottle. It must have been 3 or 4 times. I don't remember all of the details of what was written on the rolled up paper within the bottles, but it is impossible to forget the sensation of finding one. A 7 or 8 year old child who comes across a message in a bottle finds himself at the center of a world that feels both incomprehensibly large and truly small, all in the same instant. The experience opens up opportunities and horizons that were unknown just a moment before, but now feel close and connected and possible. Later in college in California, I had a friend on my hallway who grew up on the coast in Bellingham, Washington. His childhood home was on a bluff overlooking Puget Sound with a rocky beach at the bottom. And I asked him once if he had ever found a message in a bottle. He sort of looked at me and chuckled. "That doesn't happen in real life," he said. "You're either really lucky or someone was planting them for you." We asked a few classmates who had spent time on the shore and other places. None of them had ever found a message in a bottle either. How could this have happened? I had found 3 or 4 over the span of maybe 6 or 7 years, and no one else I knew had ever found one ever. I thought about it a little bit more. Every time that I could recall finding a message in a bottle, at least that I could remember, I had been with my dad. Huh. The image in my head of what the messages inside had looked like, you know, that handwriting did look a little bit familiar. So I confronted my dad about this, and he completely denied planting them on the beach for me to find. They were real, he said. And if you know my dad, a guy who has marched in the Brookline Flag Day parade dressed as Recycle Man, he is not one to litter. So I'm still not sure whether or not to believe him. Was I just lucky, or had my father planted them? But I figured out later that the answers to those questions don't really matter, because in a larger sense, my dad and my mom were planting thousands of messages in bottles all throughout my childhood. Every time they read Where the Wild Things Are or Green Eggs and Ham at bedtime, every time they took me to the Science Museum or a national park or a historic site in downtown Boston, they were planting messages in bottles everywhere my sister, Allison, and I went, figuratively and perhaps sometimes even literally. Each of these experiences generated wonder and awe and a sense of opportunity, all made possible by my parents. And whether you have recognized it or not, the people who raised you and turned you into the promising adults that you are today have for years been doing exactly the same thing my parents did. They taught you how to ride a bike or how to swim. They got you up early in the morning to get on the Metco bus. They brought you to the United States. They helped you with multiplication tables and algebra. Just last week, they were helping you get ready for prom. Some of you still need them to look your best, even if you don't want to admit it. And of course, those who planted these bottles also include your teachers, coaches, guidance counselors, and administrators at HBS. Some of the most dedicated and effective educators on the planet. So while it is an honor to be with you today, and it is just as much an honor to be with the people who helped make you who you are. You earned this diploma, but make no mistake, you didn't get here by yourself. This brings me to the first of my 3 asks of you, and this is the easy of the 3. After this ceremony, say thank you to the people who raised you and taught you and made enormous sacrifices to help you succeed. One of the most important things your family did is to get you into the Brookline Public Schools. I recall my senior year AP European History teacher, Mr. Dudley, telling us the first day of class in room 384, the big room right above the library. Many of you in this class will go to fancy colleges and graduate schools, he said, but you will never have classmates as talented and exceptional as the ones in this classroom. And I think he was right. This is a community that prizes and values education. Last month's townwide vote to raise property taxes and improve and expand the high school is just the most recent example of that commitment. But the physical structures of the Brookline Public Schools are a small part of what makes them so special. It's actually about the people. You have been surrounded with outstanding and diverse peers who have made you a better student, a better citizen, a better friend. The world outside of Brookline's borders does not necessarily look like this. As you head off to college or the workforce or the military, unless your parents are like really clingy and overbearing, or if they're helicopter parents who actually own a helicopter, there are fewer opportunities for them to walk a little bit ahead of you and drop the plastic bottles with notes in them for you to find. You are going to need to intentionally surround yourself with people who will help you thrive, people who are smart and generous and kind and passionate, people who are good human beings and great at contributing something to others in their community. That all came easily, even unconsciously, at Brookline High School. It will not come so easily elsewhere, even at the fancy colleges that many of you will be attending later this year. So my second ask is that in the next step of your life, whether it's college or the workforce or something else, you proactively surround yourself with people who are good and great. Find the people who have the qualities and character you want for yourself and let those rub off on you, just as they have done at BHS. I think Yama and Salam said, you're defined by the people who are around you. My third and final request is the hardest, but maybe the most important. Get involved with democracy. I know many of you do not need this encouragement. You have already demonstrated you are ready to contribute and lead in charting the direction of our state and country. You have shuddered at the atrocities at Marjory Stoneman Douglas High School, and like your peers in Florida, used it as an opportunity to educate and act and bring change. You have marched in the Women's March and the Science March and the March for Our Lives. Perhaps one thing the Trump administration has been good for is that it helps us regularly get in our 10,000 steps. And you have grappled with and confronted issues of race and language that have pulled your community apart and I hope in some ways also brought it back together. Those of you who have been engaged, thank you and keep it up. Those of you who have not yet been engaged, we need you. The Clinton administration official and writer Eric Liu has observed that in a democracy, power is infinite. It sounds a little bit naive, it sounds a little bit new agey, but he means it concretely in this sense. In civic life, it is possible to generate power out of thin air where it did not exist before, simply by organizing. The current allocation of power is not fixed or finite. If you learn how to organize your classmates or your neighbors, how to make a persuasive speech, use social media, even just how to make some dank political memes to stir up interest in a cause, you haven't at all diminished anyone else's ability to do the same thing. All you've done is added to the net amount of power in civic life. This is not altogether obvious. I'd been involved in politics for about a decade before I truly understood it. In 2013 and 2014, some powerful and wealthy people, including 6 of the 10 most powerful people in Boston, according to Boston Magazine's annual rankings, got together and decided it would be a good idea to bid on the 2024 Olympics. Knowing the Olympics' disastrous history in other cities, and that the International Olympic Committee requires host governments to sign a guarantee that taxpayers will cover cost overruns, a few friends and I believed a Boston bid was truly a bad idea. But as we looked around at the watchdog institutions that would normally raise questions about the implications and costs of a bid, they were all silent. Opposition to the booster's proposal was going to have to come from regular people like us. So the three of us formed No Boston Olympics in my friend's living room, simply by creating a Twitter handle. By January of 2015, when the United States Olympic Committee chose Boston over bids from Los Angeles, Washington, D.C., and San Francisco, the boosters pushing Boston 2024 were beating us by 20 points in the public opinion polls. They'd raised and spent $10 million to our $10,000. That's 1,000 to 1. They had the mayor of Boston and a long list of politicians supporting their effort. But we had the facts on our side and some incredible volunteers, and we got organized. We started with the two ends of the political spectrum. Progressive Democrats who wanted their tax dollars spent on education and healthcare instead of stadiums, and Tea Party Republicans who didn't want their tax dollars spent on anything. We worked from those ends toward the middle and found that the more Massachusetts voters learned about the Olympic bid, the less they liked it. By March, the poll numbers had flipped, and a majority of voters had come around to our side. Boston 2024 limped along for another 4 months before the USOC and the boosters threw in the towel in late July, calling the grassroots opposition unprecedented. The allocation of civic power had not been fixed or finite. The people who have power and control today will not necessarily have them tomorrow. Most of you will get to vote in November in the first federal election since the scariest presidential election in my lifetime. You need to vote, but I ask you to do more than vote. Get involved with democracy. If you want to take power from the NRA, or reduce air pollution and greenhouse gas emissions, or reform our agricultural programs to provide more nutritious food, or make our government more responsible with our tax dollars, or you want more parks or more bike lanes or safer crosswalks, all of that is up to you. Those things will only happen when you get involved and stay involved in our democracy. I know that you are up to that challenge, and I ask you to take it on. So here's the TLDR. Number one, say thank you to your parents and teachers. Number two, surround yourself with people who make you a better person. Number three, get involved in our democracy. We need you. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2018.
Our head of school, Mr. Anthony Meyer, will now present the class.
All right, so Mr. Superintendent Bott, I present the class of 2018, having met their requirements. And now I think it is your role to accept the class.
So, class of 2018, you have listened to a lot. I'm going to keep my remarks in my pocket and just say one thing. You often hear Mr. Meyer talk about the vast conspiracy of adults that surround you, that have supported you, that have uplifted you. And I want you to take one look around you, because this is that vast conspiracy that has been with you from the start. And just because today is your graduation doesn't mean that this group of adults isn't still with you. What it means is that you are now part of this conspiracy. And it is with great honor, and it is my distinct pleasure to accept you as the class of 2018, having met your graduation requirements, and confer upon you your diplomas. I am thrilled that you will be joining this entire group, fighting for change locally, in our state, in our nation, in our world. We welcome you to this conspiracy. Congratulations.
We ready to roll? Wait. Yeah? Kelly, should I start?
Nope.
Okay.
Okay. Are we ready?
Okay.
Go
ahead. Okay. Melissa Boo. Emily Abbott. Lily Abrams. Mia Abulaf. Nada Aladdin. Lizzie Allen. Jason Altshuler. Ava Kathleen Amato Bauer. Hunter Amory. Saren Anderson Huggins. Beatrice Andraji. Sophie Arnstein. Ilana Aronson. Marlon Asensio. Mateo Escario Victoria. Elena Assad. Ori Ayalon. Elizabeth Bailey. William Banks. Chloe Barber. David Barnes. Otman Barilli. Evelyn Barrios. Dan Basav. Helen Beckler. Mikaeus Bekele. Ilya Belkin. Avi Benmeyer. Raphael Baer. Liana Bergman Turnbull. Can we get a selfie? Cyprian Besson.
Thank you very much.
Sonia Bhattacharya. Claire Bialek. Heidi Birch. Robert Bizier. Bishmans Blanchard. Ava Blashkevich. Jan Block. Dominique Bachman. Dania Bogdanovich. Raven Bogues. Jake Boyd. Nicholas John Bradley Gogol. Shai Branover. Carolyn Briggle. Benjamin Bromberg. Nicholas Brown. Olivia Brown. Ethan Brownell. Julian Brummett. Elizabeth Budden. Cora Bundy. Mia Pitter Kamhai. David Kaplan. Admilton Carvalho. Ariane Chakar Baru. Elena Chamberlain. Emerson Chandler. Sydney Chase. Zakir Chaudhry. Brandon Chen. Shinjit Chen. Tamron Cheng. Cannon Chu. Ashley Choi. Tylo Chow. Cecilia Cipolo. Laura Cisneros Garcia. Jacob Seville. Joseph Clark. Edon Cohen. Jacob Michael Cohen. Jacob Ross Cohen. Benjamin Collins. Kayla Blair Collins. Nicole Collins. Nathan Comerchero. Ariana Contente. Mary Corcoran. Isabel Cotney. Nathaniel Cox. Arisette Cox. Arisette Cruz. Penelope Cruz. Tatiana Danahy Moore. Samuel Davies. Michaela Davis. Daishan Day. Eleanor Decker Gavin. Kevin Desire. Ava DiStefano 40. Ellen Dlamini. Philip Dorfman. Jeremy Dowdy. Liam Downey. Max Dubay. Olivia Dubay. Max Duchenne. Olivia. Zoe DeCrew. Alex Ducon. Evangeline Una Ernest. Makai Jawan Edgewallis. Camille L. Issaway. Daisy Elliott. Ava Ernst. Andrew Irvin. Darvinsley Esperance. Juliette Estime. Yamanuchi Estime. Connor Aegis. Eli Fibel. Jarek Feliciano. Chloe Fisher. Kayla Flashman. Christopher Fontenot. Carolina Fuchs. Daniela Fuentes Hernandez. Naomi Fakuda. Christian Gaeta. Ethan Gainsborough. Quinn Gangadarin. Michelle Garcia Gracias. Diego Garcia Mendez. Emily Gardner. Taishwan Gale. Jake Geller. Marco Georgiaklis. Vandana George. Andrew Gerber. Emily Gerson. Andrew Geschichter. Esther Gilbert. Evelyn Gilbert. Sophia Glazerman. Sophie Glusman. Maor Goyberg. Roy Golan. Shira Golan. Alexander Goldman. Jillian Goldstein. Isabel Gonzalez. Dominique Gopal. Kenji Godo Hardy. Asher Gottlieb. Jalen Gould, her diploma is being presented by her mother, Bonnie Hatch, kitchen catering manager at BHS. Sophie Greer. Rafael Grieco. Emma Grinspoon. Sarah Graustra. Talia Gruber. Kevin Guo. Grace Gutterman. Joanne Gutierrez. Sammy Gattel. Peter Ha. Krikor Hajan. Masha Hancharova. Lena Harris. Her diploma is being presented by her mother, Lisa Lamont Harris, team facilitator, Brookline Early Education Program. Shahar Hartman. Isabella Hartshorn. Timothy Hartshorn. Tyler Haynes. Nathan Hazen. Miriam Hecht. Henry Heffen. Emmanuel Henry. Chris Hernandez. Richard Charles Hollander. Maya Janina Bopana Hertz. Sean Higgins. Phineas Hilliard. Sonia Hills. Yael Hod. Kelly Hong. Eric Howe. His diploma is being presented by his father, Joshua Howe, vice president at the Baker School. Isabel Howell. Momoko Howell. Wilson Chu. Petra Huang. Scott Huang. Amar Hussein. Simon Ivchevich. Henry Isakovich. Emily Jack. Alexander Jacobs. Evan Jacobson. Ayman Jagani. Logan James. Ethan Jampel. Chloe Janes. Kartik Jayachandran. Abigail Janes. Todd Jennings. Chloe Jepson. Lyra Johnson. Leahy Kadosh. Liam Kaplan. Maya Cassis. Salam Kasu. Allison Keenan. Dylan Kelly. Emerson Kelly.
Congratulations.
Susanna Kemp. Ronit Kempler. Lucas Kerman. Max Kerman. Iman Khan. Richard Kazanov. Sophia Kudyakov. David Kim. Moonjung Kim. Patrick Kim. Benjamin Kimia. Donovan Michael Crane. Ella Kitterman. Elliot Coe. Pierre A. Kochi. Rahul Kaluri. Daria Komernitsky. Laura Kapodienko. Thomas Kosa. Delia Krasansky. Mari Kuwabara Wag. Brent Lacey. Ronald Lamb. Talia Langton. Nicholas Lapidus. Alicia Lau. Luke Legarek. Isabel Leader. Jonah Lecker. Yunsik Lee. Miles Leong. Crawford Lepree. Ryan Leung.
I'm here.
Hal, you want Jimmy to start? Jimmy Ricks. Henry Levinson. Sophia Levin. Amy Levine. Clara Levrero. Emily Liu. Jackson Lewitt. Angie Lee. Michael Lee. Mike Lee. Victor Lee. Nathaniel Lieberman. Christina Lima. Thank you, sir. Courtney Lima. Yeah. Samuel Lichman. Yeah. Cynthia Liu. Yeah. Diane Liu. Fiona Lobon. Isabel Lobon. Maeja Ellen Lopez. Karina Lorenzo. Nathan Lurie. Sophia McLean. Ariel Majar. Felix Madsen Hardy. Lauren Mahoney. Alexandra Mayella. Shalini Maitra. Noah Mamane. Benjamin Mandel. Leanne Marone. Oh. Claudia Martza. Rebecca Mason. Abigail Mason. Justin Matheri. Ani Matheson. Alexis Machuson. Kyle McCauley Pomeroy. Gabriel McDonough Swami. Nicholas McDowell. William McCain. Nathan McGuire. Hugh McKenzie. Francis McMillan. Romy Meehan. Timothy May. Kyle Mello. Eli Mendels. Bailey Mendez-Rainey. Victor Mercola. Ana Merida. Sebastian Merida. Ayasamichi. Itai Milatiner. Noah Milatiner. Keelan Miller. Paul Miller Schmidt. De'Asia Milton. Adrian Mims. Ian Mitchell. Peter Montgomery. Sophie Morgenstern. Benjamin Moyer. Alexandra Mundus. Jacqueline Mundus. Max Murphy. Rachel Myers. Aiden Nagel. Madeline Nagler. Caroline Nagel. Jacob Najjar. Josue Navarro Duarte. Varun Nayar. Sophia Noble. Dashiell Nussbaum. Spencer Nussbaum. Lucia O'Brien. Michael O'Day. Hayden O'Dell. Cameron O'Neill. Connor O'Neill. Amara Obiora. David Ophir. Yunus Usoy. Maya Page. Maria Pagunas. Hannah Stern Pite. Aaron Pan. Karen Pan. Camille Park. Lucy Park. Carolyn Parker Fairbairn. Nicholas Partan. Mansi Patel. Sarah Peng. Rachel Percy. Nelson Nicolas Paulino Bruno. Clarice Pertel. Quinn Michaela Peters. Noah Petler. Darnell Pierre. Darnell's diploma is being presented by Darnell's brother, Jeffrey Pierre, paraprofessional in the RISE program at BHS. Emily Pikin. Lena Ponce. Anthony Porco. Mayavati Prabhakar. Nina Prilak. Abigail Prashong. Lisa Radin. Amir Radmand. Samuel Ray. Tiara Ranson. Sam Rasul. Annabelle Ray. Olivia Reese. Her mother, Oakley Hirth, from the sixth grade at Devotion, is presenting her diploma. Perea Reich. Oliver Resnick. Catherine Reyes Aguilar. Olivia Rier. Dante Riley. Imanol Rios Franco. Ethan Riss. Carl Ritter von Wagner. John Roach. Oscar Rodas. Tyler Rogers. Spencer Regovin. Denise Rogozin. Felicia Rosen. Joshua Rosenthal. Ollie Rossi. Josephine Rauterbusch. Maya Rosen. Alvin Ruan. Olivia Rukenstein. Samuel Russo. Jacob Sachs. Bradford Sains. Lily Saki. Joely Sanchez. Ethan Saunders. Anthony, hold on, who's Ethan's the next child? Anthony Saunders. Ethan Schaefer. Logan Schaefer. Rebecca Shine. Natalie Scher. Mitchell Schroeder. Dan Schwartz. Yoni Siegel. Olivia Seidelman. Bronwyn Sell. Rachel Selvin. Noah Sessling. Henry Schaefer. Nilab Sharma. Abigail Clara Sharon. Maya Shaughnessy. Omri Shavit. Bridget Shea. Gabriel Sherman. Stella Schiffman. Her diploma being presented to her by her father, Gary Schiffman, Social Studies Coordinator at BHS. Alex Scheinman. Rio Shimbori. Megha Srivastava. Jessica Seibert. Maximus Say. Peter Silva. Ariana Silver. Max Silverman. Claire Slattery. Alexander Slayton. Felix Smith. Hannah Smith. Aditya Soni. Isabel Souza. Diart Spahia. Matthew Steele. Susan Steinfield. Ty Stevenson. Zeppo Strauss. Emily Strait. Samuel Strom. Nicholas Sturman. Colleen Summers. Suhan Sung. Douglas Zito. Hibiki Tabayuchi. Takeuchi. Ariana Tecker. Irina Turovenet. I practice this so much. Turovenesian. Victoria Turovenesian. Henry Terry. Owen Thoft Brown. Herbie Torres. Jared Toe. Yu Uchiyama. Sage Ull. Abraham von Overbeck Costello. Daria Veraxa. Belando Vissier. Avi Veder. Senka Anthony Vieri. Rachel Vinn. Nadia Vitek. Karina Von Yoon. Her diploma being presented by her mother, Monica Von Yoon, program coordinator for Brookline Adult Education. Talia Voss. Henry Walker. Marcella Walsh. Christopher Wan. Julia Vong. Shiyumu Wong. David Warfield. Koma Wasif. Robert Watkins. Elizabeth Webler. Chen Yu Wei. Hope Wei. Timothy Weigart. Nathaniel Weldon. Andrea Wetzler. Sean Whelan. Sonia Wysek. Gabriel Weiss. Joseph Willen. Justin Wolfel. Sasha Wolf-Sorokin. Sebastian Wood. Angela Igishu. Ohad Yahalom. Matthew Yee. Christina Ya. Evan Yu. Bianca Yornet. Afik Zarur. Jaru Yang. Give me a high. Give me a high. Congratulations. Jacob Zachary Flanders. Melody Joe. Zitao Joe. Brian Jew. XJ Jew. And Michael Zimmerman Lemus.
Okay, class of 2018, it is time to move that tassel. Congratulations.
We're gonna sing, then they can throw it.
Great. Let's also just thank Mr. Butchart and Ms. Davis for reading all of those names.
Now, if you would turn to the back of your program. One final song. Before we celebrate, we will sing our alma mater, led by Dean Scott Butchart.
And Dean Redding.
Do they stand or no?
Yeah, of course. Don't have any voice left.
Class of 2018, please stand.
Of all the high schools passing by, there's none that can compare. There's none so rare and none so fair as dear old Brookline High. So hoist your banners to the sky, swear allegiance true, for we are proud to stand and cheer for Brookline's red and blue. Hey!
All right, class of 2018, you are now proud graduates of Brookline High School. Congratulations. Thank you to everyone. Have a nice afternoon.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you so much.
Well done.